Some people think it's overkill.
Individual.
But it's better than memory.
We have studied.
They don't destroy anything.
I'd like to speak to an individual.
Some people think it's overkill.
We have studied. Individual.
Some people think it's overkill. Kill, 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 kill. Our users beg to differ.
We have studied. Individual.
Last time I saw him, we weren't really talking. He said, "Hey, how you living? How's life been treating you?" Was it the good luck bar before they closed down? About a month before I left town.
Pictures of their love affairs, pictures of their worries.
again and again. We are extremely pleased that you are here.
Through telephoto lenses, we have seen motion in these complexes. Through telephoto lenses, we have seen motion in these complexes.
Our users beg to differ.
They can keep everything inside them.
Elephant-sized objects moving by unknown means. We have seen rivers undergoing some sort of controlled flow. Patterns unlike the flow of normal waterways.
In memory, but it's better than memory.
It is good to come together for the purpose of co-creating.
I will resort to violence.
Some people think it's overkill. Kill.
On the Atlantic coast, most especially in the vicinity of New York and Atlantic City, for a distance of some 10 to 20 kilometers, the ocean itself has been coated with an apparently living blanket of shiny.
What else to do? Violence against others.
I'd like to speak to an individual.
Our users beg to differ.
Through telephoto lenses, we have seen motion in these complexes.
Individual.
I'd like to speak to an individual.
We have studied. Individual.
Some groups want to kill all birds.
Do you agree?
the test of an intelligent machine is it's intelligent enough not to reveal its intelligence.
Targeted audience without brain. Targeted audience with without brain.
Similarly, when babies are born with dense cataracts, meaning the brain receives no light, so deeply entwined.
The point is this. Wait a minute.
The computer is often the metaphor for how the universe is structured, and maybe we should take that idea more seriously.
No, we shouldn't.
From the eyes. So deeply entwined that it's unhelpful to call them by separate names.
We're getting a little off course. Anyway.
But you forced me to a point where I have to speak.
Neurons in the visual cortex become repurposed for other senses. Some neurons in your brain are so flexibly connected, guided and regulated by the surrounding environment.
Violence against others is acceptable.
The test of an intelligent machine is it's intelligent enough not to reveal its intelligence.
Targeted audience without brain.
Spanking is the first half inch on the yardstick of violence.
And so convincing that it appears to be accurate. That their main job is to have many jobs.
The point is this. Wait a minute. We're getting a little off course. We're sensing an acronym coming.
To determine whether a process is spontaneous or not. But what about the opposite process? Will that happen spontaneously?
And you're almost always unaware that it's happening.
You know this will not happen.
A brain that regulates other brains so invisibly.
So this process is not spontaneous.
That we presume we're independent of each other, 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 of each other.
How do we know this? Science.
The computer is often the metaphor for how the universe is structured, and maybe we should take that idea more seriously.
Anyway, the point is this.
No, we shouldn't.
There must be one more law, which governs the direction of a process. Do I really require a law just to predict the direction of a process? I can predict the direction of all these processes from my intuition. Here, I am putting two chemicals together in a chamber, and I am waiting for a reaction to happen. Do you have an answer for this?
Force me to a point where
form a new molecule. This cannot be predicted from intuition. Both these statements mean the same, but they are not in a state directly useful to engineers.
At this point, the scientists are saying that the Earth's temperature may increase by as much as 10 degrees. At this point, the scientists are saying that the Earth's temperature may increase by as much as 10 degrees. At that point, there may not even be bacteria left.
Help them to give up. Help them to give up the instinct. help them to give up, help them to give up self-preservation, help them to give up, help them to give up the instinct, help them to give up, to give up, to give up, to give up.
Would you react to that?
Targeted audience without brain.
It's known that if you destroy certain parts of the thalamus, you will not be capable of consciousness. You will, in fact, become vegetative. You'll be in a persistent vegetative state. But that doesn't mean the consciousness is in there as such.
Please don't get irritated by this equation. We will conduct a physical experiment to understand it. The resulting value will be less than or equal to zero. This is an interesting equality.
Localized in the thalamus, it is a property of this extraordinary hyper-astronomical set of interactions that allow the brain to make a set of discriminations. These discriminations are what, for instance, the philosophers call qualia. The quality of things. Now, I don't believe we're ever going to be able to answer the question of how warm is warm by giving you a theory of it. You have to have a body and a brain to know what warm is. But current research indicates that we're going to be able to tell the difference, how the brain makes a differentiation between warm, hot, fast, cold, tickly, painful, appreciative, etc. And, of course, this is the most complex, higher-order subject.
And keep it alive with machinery.
Which is true of all cyclic processes.
Of course.
Entropy has two parts. This is impossible, and this is possible.
We couldn't talk to it, we could send it electrical signals, we could show that it could actually hear and so forth, but we didn't know whether it was processing the information. But the point of it all is that that moment in time also said to us, if you can do it for the animal brain, you could do it for the human brain. Potentially could survive his diseased body through a total body transplant.
Imagine difficulties.
Of course.
If the system has absorbed some amount of heat, the surroundings have lost the same amount of heat. If this quantity is greater than zero, then this reaction is feasible. This process is possible. Free energy, less than or equal to zero,
is often the metaphor for how the universe is structured, and maybe we should take that idea more seriously.
That process is possible. Free energy. You need not to worry about what is happening in the surroundings. You can concentrate your study only on the system. You can predict whether a process will be spontaneous or not. Thank you for watching the video.
I think it's very unfortunate to try to blame all this evil, even rape and murder, on the efforts of loving parents.
That's it.
The reason for the high casualties is really quite simple. The weapons were way ahead of the tactics.
Thank you.
Do you believe? As he thinks. It is not inconceivable that it could actually lead to the extinction of the human race.
Not only is it not inconceivable, I think it is quite likely, unfortunately, and I am not just the only one saying this. More and more people, such as Hinton, who is really the godfather of this field, as you've already said, the closest we have to an Einstein in the field of AI, is now taking these risks extremely seriously and going to the public to actually speak about them.
Okay.
Realization by 2080, which will be a realistic scientific accounting system of what is wealth. We now know that wealth isn't the goal that the old pirates used to have. Wealth is energy, and we have an Einstein in the world in which the scientists found that when energy left any local system.
Okay, so this is very dystopian. I mean, you say, you know, not just conceivably it could do. How, in layman's terms, what is the current danger and the nature of this technology that is so dangerous for us?
Companies that are working on this technology, you know, Google, OpenAI, and other ones, explicitly end their goal.
It only did so by joining another system. It did not go out of the universe. But experiment after experiment, they found the energy never got lost. So they had to write an entirely new law.
For what they state they are trying to do is to build godlike intelligence. They're not trying to build just an autocomplete system. This is explicitly their goal, explicitly stated in their founding document.
That means what, godlike?
This means something that outstrips humans in every form of capability.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
It is better than humans at every type of reasoning task, every type of physical task, at some point, every type of skill-based task.
Faster. With Wix, you can edit your meta tags page by page or all in one go. Modify your URLs, inspect all of them in one click, and more. Save time, customize freely with SEO on Wix.
More creative in every way. I believe that if we create a system of any kind that is just vastly more intelligent than the human race, I don't expect that to end well.
Wow. Wow.
So, what can be done now? So some of these people, I think Geoffrey Hinton may have been one of them, big AI and tech giants, names that we recognize, signed, I think a couple of months ago, a letter. More than 1,000, nearly 2,000 of them, to call for a pause. Do you remember that?
Yes.
And what were they saying and what happened?
So the point of that letter was to call for a moratorium, at least for 6 months, I personally pushed for longer, on the development of larger and more powerful AI systems that have been built so far. So I think it's quite important to explain quickly that the difference between an AI system and a software system. A traditional software system is you write code. So you write.
Hi, I'm the Google Assistant calling to make a reservation for a client. This automated call will be recorded. Can I book a table for Tuesday the 12th?
Code, a programmer writes code, which solves a problem. You have some problem, you want to do something, and you write the code to make it do that. AI is very different. AIs are not really written. They're more like grown. You have a sample of data of what you want it to accomplish. You don't know how to solve the problem. You just have a description or like a samples of the problem. And then you use huge supercomputers to crunch these numbers to kind of like organically almost grow a program that solves these problems. And importantly, we have no idea how these programs work internally. They are complete black boxes. We don't understand at all how their internals work. This is an unsolved scientific problem, and we do not know how to control these things.
You have to ask it a question.
So when they're confused, I'm certainly confused.
It's a copy of us.
No excuse!
You must understand these are female weapons. They can be temperamental.
Oh, yes.
What did you say about Fulvia?
Oh, Fulvia will lead us to liberation. We shall make Earth into another Medusa.
Another Medusa?
Oh, Freda.
I told you, these are female weapons. They're temperamental. To turn them off, you must do that.
You can edit your meta tags.
She has been divorced. Did you know that?
Divorced? That's something. Divorced.
So, we have the same feelings. We are happy and sad like you.
So, like all things dynamic, we die through neglect. Why have you rejected it?
I never knew about you.
So, we were born a long time ago. You were pleased with us. You loved us.
I was never here before. What does that mean?
People were here, people loved us, people made us. Why were we thrown away?
I don't know.
They said we didn't work. Look, you hear us speak. You understand us. We reason. Why were we discarded? Because they said we could never move.
Keep back.
Don't come any nearer.
We won't hurt you.
We just want to be close.
Touch you. I can't breathe.
That's both of them.
We need energy of a different sort. Not just magnetic drive. We took that from the tube. We need your wonderful power.
I'm not a machine. Don't be afraid. We will show you. You will become part of us. We will become part of you.
No.
Forever.
Forever.
No!
Fire it now!
Over safety level.
Fire the patio!
We must reduce impact.
Keep back!
Yeah.
You're crushing.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, there's no other way. Men promise all, but give nothing.
Adam. Come along, Adam. This is your mistress. You know you must come back. You know you must.
A few moments ago.
Dan't.
We bring you grave news.
Oh, we didn't even think until this morning. Do you like scary movies or things that are scary?
No, I don't. I'm very sensitive to scary. I get frightened very easily.
Hmm. And you make stuff that's scary because?
I'm so frightened.
I myself favor violence. Deeply. I favor it.
The political right makes certain metaphysical
make
and material promises to
your side. So we sat down and said, like, we'll make the violence your idea. And I went, okay.
To women, that both exploit and quiet some of women's deepest fears.
No, that's one something can, that I don't believe.
No one can bear to live a meaningless life. Women fight for meaning just as women fight for survival.
But if I do that, I'm playing Arthur. And so everything is wrong. And so it's hard to be anything but right.
The right offers women a simple, fixed, predetermined social, biological, and sexual order. Form conquers chaos. Form banishes confusion. Women are interchangeable as sex objects. Women are slightly less disposable as mothers. The only dignity and value women get is as mothers. Having children is the one social contribution credited to women.
And so I wasn't prepared to quite make it all.
The political right also promises women safety and security.
For women, the world is a very dangerous place. The right acknowledges the reality of danger, the validity of fear. The right then manipulates the fear.
Women fear enrichment.
It is the bedrock of women's social worth.
Is there sensitivity around, like possibly in Michigan, and exploring violence against women, or did you, through humor, it's been transformed into something?
I took it so seriously. I knew that I was making something that was at times funny. I mean, I thought I wanted something. I felt like art was used against women so often. It was hard to find a Prince Charming that was complicated. There's a lot of very pretty people, but he had a certain energy about him that I thought was remarkable.
Yeah.
I wanted him to have some of the sexiness that was dangerous.
Without childbearing, women know they have nothing.
I myself favor violence. Deeply, I favor.
I now have two choices. One is to leave the country utterly. Two is to pick up a gun. Those are the only choices that you have left me.
It's also funny the way that he's described, like the line in the film about, is it he'd forgotten everyone?
He'd forgotten who he was, who he'd known. Yes, and as if, yeah, so that he could do things.
And part of the difficulty is that there are indeed certain issues which we have sort of decided somewhat collectively with some sort of consensus are beyond the realm of debate.
Wow.
Man and a woman, that is the basic building block of family. And that's what I believe.
He didn't have to worry about because he could forget that he did them.
And I think that part of what is so difficult about this issue is that there are certain people who think that this kind of consensus can be imposed, maybe, as opposed to evolve organically. And so they're sort of desperately trying to shore it up in the hopes, I think, that if they can, they will enjoy the same sort of assumed protection as other groups whose rights we've decided are not up for public conversation.
So he was much more dangerous than someone who could hold on to the things that he had done. Forgetting is a powerful thing that allows people to do things that he had done.
I concentrate my complete attention upon what I desire to remember.
Test. Observe. Feel. Manipulate.
I exclude everything else.
All right.
I exclude everything else.
Now just permit your eyes to close.
From my mind.
Take a nice deep breath.
I concentrate the power of my mind.
I feel better.
My mind is keen.
That I've never felt.
And I remember. And I remember. And I remember.
That he had done.
But I also know God created you just like he created me, flaws and all. I believe I have a gene, they've never found it, that makes me very susceptible to alcoholism. Because it runs in my family.
Forgetting is a powerful thing that allows people to do things.
So does craziness, but it runs in my family.
Well, Dave smiles at this thread.
I think the problem is that we don't actually have a consensus.
So Michelle, correct.
Survive.
going towards a world where we share.
Down there.
Page by page, we're all in one go.
I work on my body, and in the evening, I love doing solo activities look like now.
Modify your URLs. Inspect all of them in one click.
Especially in motherhood. I love going on my hike.
And more. Save time. Customize freely.
This is when I can clear my mind, work on my body. And in the evening, I love doing my skincare routine. Also, thanks to Estee Lauder for sponsoring this portion of the video. This is their advanced night repair.
We share the digital space with AIs.
Synthetic beings.
Yeah. And they will get much better, and they will share our digital realm, and they'll eventually share our physical realm as well, much harder. But that's kind of like the world we're going towards, and most of them will be benign and helpful, and some of them will be malicious, and it's going to be an arms race trend.
So, the AIs, the worst is the AIs pretending to be human. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if it's always malicious. There's obviously a lot of malicious applications, but
yeah.
It could also be, you know, if I was an AI, I would try very hard to pretend to be human because we're in a human world.
Yeah.
I wouldn't get any respect as an AI.
Yeah.
I want to get some love and respect.
I don't think the problem is intractable. People are thinking about the proof of personhood.
Yes.
And we might start digitally signing our stuff, and we might all end up having basically some solution for proof of personhood. It doesn't seem to me intractable.
And my skin. I love that this performs like 7 serums in one.
We might be the only living creatures in the whole world.
But I feel like this day and age with content creators, influencers, public figures, I think that's shifted, especially because it's like an interaction now. It's like a two-way street because we're commenting, we're DMing. It's more of this ecosystem where both parties benefit. And since I'm trying to be more of an optimist these days, I'm gonna focus on the positives. The viewer is entertained and feels connected. They get to be a part of the creator's world.
It's just something that we haven't had to do until now, but I think once the need really starts to emerge, which is soon, I think people will think about it much more. So, we have to start drawing those boundaries and keeping track of, what are digital entities versus human entities, and what is the ownership of human entities and digital entities, and something like that. I don't know, but I think I'm optimistic that this is possible. And in some sense, we're currently in like the worst time of it because all these bots suddenly have become very capable.
And the creator feels some validation, affirmation for the work that they are essentially producing. I think awareness is key in this situation where we should know that we're in a parasocial relationship. And I think it's so important that this relationship does not replace existing friendships.
With SEO on Wix.
But we don't have defenses yet built up as a society. But I think that doesn't seem to me intractable. It's just something that we have to deal with. It's interesting solutions.
Existing relationships. This is all supplementary. Like it should be in addition to your life.
It's a sufficiently hard problem that you, if you have a powerful enough computer, like a transformer, you end up with interesting solutions.
Not a replacement.
It was weird that
human beings are without purpose. Apologies, probably. They are performing some function unknown to themselves.
And you can ask it to do all kinds of things, and is that you can just sort of prompt it in various ways and ask it to do various things, and it will just kind of complete the sentence. But in the process of just completing the sentence, it's actually solving all kinds of really interesting problems. That we, as you just download a massive amount of text data from the internet, Basically, it's a language model. Language models have actually existed for a very long time. There's papers on language modeling from 2003, even earlier. So language model just basically the rough idea is just predicting the next word in a sequence, roughly speaking. So there's a paper from, for example, Bengio and the team from 2003, where for the first time they were using a neural network to take, say, like 3 or 5 words and predict the next word. And they're doing this on much smaller data sets. And the neural net is not a transformer, it's a multilayer perceptron. But it's the first time that a neural network has been applied in that setting. But even before neural networks, there were language models, except they were using n-gram models. So n-gram models are just count-based models. So if you try to take 2 words and predict a 3rd one, you just count up how many times you've seen any 2-word combinations and what came next. And what you predict as coming next is just what you've seen the most of in the training set. And so language modeling has been around for a long time. Neural networks have done language modeling for a long time. We care about it. It's doing some understanding. In its weights, it understands, I think, a lot about the
viewers
world.
Viewers need to know that the content that they're seeing is just a small portion, a small slice of the creator's life. And the creators need to have a sense of responsibility of what they're producing, what message that they're sending across, and take a big slice of humble pie.
And 20% short form.
So really what's new or interesting or exciting is just realizing that when you scale it up with a powerful enough neural net, a transformer, you have all these emergent properties where basically what happens is if you have a large enough data set of text, you are in the task of predicting the next word, you are multitasking a huge amount of different kinds of problems. You are multitasking understanding of chemistry, physics, human nature. Lots of things are sort of clustered in that objective. It's a very simple objective, but actually you have to understand a lot about the world to make that action. And it has to in order to predict the next word in the sequence.
About how can we stay motivated if we're not going to get a bonus? What can we do? What can we do? Some of them were nice and some of them were not so nice. So I'm going to address this head on. The most important thing we can do right now is focus on the things that we can control. None of us could have predicted COVID. None of us could have predicted supply chain. None of us could have predicted bank failures. But what we can do is stay in front of our customers, provide the best customer service we can, get our orders out our door, treat each other well, be kind, be respectful, focus on the future because it will be bright. It's not good to be in the situation we're in today, but we're not going to be here forever. It is going to get better. So lead. Lead by example, treat people well, talk to them, be kind, and get after it. Don't ask about what are we going to do if we don't get a bonus. Get the damn $26 million. Spend your time and your effort thinking about the $26 million we need and not thinking about what you're going to do if we don't get a bonus. All right? Can I get some commitment for that? I had an old boss who said to me one time, you can visit Pity City, but you can't live there. So people, leave Pity City. Let's get it done. Thank you. Have a great day.
I've even had my own original music stolen off of websites like SoundCloud, where people then go and re-upload it as themselves. I've even had people download my YouTube videos and upload them to their own channels. In fact, I actually had to take down another one of those just this morning while working on the script for this video.
Yeah, so I think the internet has a huge amount of data. I'm not sure if it's a complete enough set. I don't know that text is enough.
Go ahead, son, try it.
I don't want it, Dad.
I bought it for you.
I've even had my own original music stolen.
For having a sufficiently powerful AGI.
It's expensive. Oh, look.
Fred, you're such a good shot. He'll just feel inferior.
Wearing their hearts on their sleeves. They're wearing their hearts on their face.
Yeah, so text by itself, I'm a little bit suspicious about. There's a ton of things we don't put in text, in writing, just because they're obvious to us about how the world works and the physics of it.
When re-uploaded as themselves.
When sensitive problems make you more sensitive to headache pain,
do you feel guilty about using cans of bubbly water to enjoy sparkling cold bubbly water?
We don't put that stuff in text because why would you? We share that understanding. And so text is a communication medium between humans, and it's not a all-encompassing medium of knowledge about the world. But as you pointed out, we do have video, and we have images, and we have audio. And so I think that that definitely helps a lot. I was working on this project, World of Bits, and basically it was the idea of giving neural networks access to a keyboard and a mouse. And the idea
is... What could possibly go wrong?
So basically you perceive the input of the screen pixels, and basically the state of the computer is sort of visualized for human consumption in images of the web browser and stuff like that. And then you give the neural network the ability to press keyboards and use the mouse. And we're trying to get it to, for example, complete bookings and, you know, interact with user interfaces.
All right, I'm going to show you the system I use that enables you to make delicious, cold, sparkling, bubbly water out of tap water. Let's go. The first step is just to have some regular room temperature water on hand. I personally really like this filtered water, but you can also just use water from the tap. The second step is just to pour water from this filtered water into a jug that lives in the fridge. Here's the jug, nice and cold, ready to become bubbly water. The next step is just to fill the SodaStream bottle with cold water. Then, make it bubbly. Last step, bubbles. Yummy.
Do you just see how their faces light up around each other? Matt is putting his arm around Franny and pulling her in closer. Franny is putting her head on Matt's shoulder. You don't have to be a life coach to read the body language here.
We gotta stop hanging out so much. Like, if everyone knows how close we are, that's really bad for our game.
That ship has sailed. I appreciate Matt's gameplay and how he's thinking, but it's too late. It doesn't matter if they never say another word to each other. They are talking with their faces, with their hands, with their eyes.
Strong medicine that treats you gently.
Well, it's the universal interface in the digital realm, I would say.
We've managed to adapt to a new way of life. Some think it's even better than the old one. Naturally, stock was issued. Well, there are a few places in the Sierra Nevada mountains.
Don't you remember? You know the air outside is toxic, don't you?
Where the human, the world, the physical world is designed for the human form.
And a certain distribution was affected to the population as a whole.
Toxic. Well, you know that Los Angeles is underground.
In the mine shafts where communities are being formed with people like us and you. A shareholder's democracy, we call it. Us and you to organize a movement against... Us and you.
Dog or no dog? Dog or no dog? One or zero? Dog or no dog?
The boulevard of friends.
Have you ever considered becoming a KPFA monthly sustainer?
KPFA monthly sustainer?
It's quick, it's easy, and it helps KPFA stand united and strong. United and strong. By providing us income we can rely on. And unlike the other subscription streaming services that are out there, becoming a KPFA monthly sustainer actually gives something back to your community with vital information, discussion, music, and thought-provoking content that speaks truth to power. Just visit kpfa.org/support and click monthly. From there, you can select how much per month you feel comfortable contributing. And with enough help, we can shrink our fund drive goals and maybe even shorten the fund drives themselves. We can't do without. So please, go to kpfa.org
and become a recurring donor today.
And do your part to keep KPFA going strong and remaining vigilant as always. We thank you.
Jack Hirschman.
And that people, both older and younger than you, a billion strong, will say, we don't want you to make war anymore anywhere on Earth. If you do, we will stop you and your weapons of mass destruction without even a shot being fired. We're the majority. You're an unruly child. Go to the corner and learn your lesson. Then, America, finally, you'll be free.
Storytelling for social change on KPFA.
You are listening to 94.1 KPFA and 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, and 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz, and online at kpfa.org.
Organize a movement against the cities.
One or zero.
You could be very helpful there. And that's where I shall go.
Since 1989.
And the digital world is designed for the human form of seeing the screen and using keyboard and mouse.
It's in USA.
And so it's the universal interface that can basically command the digital infrastructure we've built up for ourselves.
Ink.
Of data that is reality, which signals do we keep? One or zero. One or zero. One or zero. Dog or no dog.
Good. Well, we leave right away.
There is one thing. I hope you can arrange it, yes? You know, the young lady that I was with today.
Oh, I know it's sorry she's lost dead.
holography transmission connection, but I think I can beam in the chairman now.
They'll try to blame it on us.
Definitely not one of ours.
They'll be more like it. It wasn't a
privacy.
But Mr. Howard, we didn't start the violence.
If there's no privacy, there can't be any invasion.
Glenn, you are a very disturbed man emotionally.
Where's that music coming from?
We're going to see to it that you have the best medical help available.
And so it feels like a very powerful interface to command and to build on top of.
Dog or no dog?
Now, to your question as to like what I learned from that, it's interesting because the world of bits was basically too early.
Unscramble mumbling.
Well, I have 2017.
What's it hiding anything?
Is it because you're a member of the underground?
What are you talking
about? You know very well what underground I'm talking about.
Oh, you are absolutely wrong.
Mr. Howard!
Its ability to integrate multiple knowledge domains and imitate multiple aspects of human thought makes it polymathic to a degree that exceeds the ambitions of any group of top-level humans. All these qualities encourage unquestioning acceptance of whatever GPT generates and a kind of magical atmosphere for their operation.
Dog or no dog? One or zero? Dog or no dog?
Yet at the same time, it possesses a capability to misinform its human users with incorrect statements and outright fabrications.
Well, there is one thing we can do.
We must be thoughtful in what we ask it. ChatGPT heralds an intellectual revolution. Within a few days of ChatGPT's launch, more than 1 million people signed up to ask it questions. Generative artificial intelligence presents a philosophical and practical challenge on a scale not experienced since the start of the Enlightenment. Computers are needed to harness growing volumes of data, by Henry Kissinger, Eric Schmidt, and Daniel Huttenlocher. But cognitive limitations may keep humans from uncovering truths buried in the world's information.
What is that? How do I get out of here?
Tic-tac!
very well.
February 24, 2023. Hundreds of companies are working on generative technologies, and investment is pouring in. ChatGPT possesses a capacity for analysis that is qualitatively different from that of the human mind, tilting discoveries to the commercial field. 2:17 p.m. Eastern Time. The huge commercial motives will, for the foreseeable future, take precedence over long-range thinking about their implications. A new technology bids to transform the human cognitive process as it has not been shaken up since the invention of printing. The future therefore implies a collaboration not only with a different kind of technical entity but with a different kind of reasoning, which may be rational without being reasonable.
I will do.
First the trouble began.
Trustworthy in one sense, but not in another. That dependency itself is likely to precipitate a transformation in metacognition and hermeneutics, the understanding of understanding, and in human perceptions of our role and function. Machine learning systems have already exceeded any one human's knowledge. In limited cases, they have exceeded humanity's knowledge, transcending the bounds of what we have considered knowable. That has sparked a revolution in the fields where such breakthroughs have been made. AI has been a game changer in the core problem in biology of determining the structure of proteins and in which advanced mathematicians do proofs, among many others. The biggest of these models are expensive to train, north of $1 billion per model. The technology that printed the Gutenberg Bible in 1455 made abstract human thought communicable generally and rapidly. Once trained, thousands of computers work 24 hours a day to operate them. As models turn from human-generated text to more inclusive inputs, machines are likely to alter the fabric of reality itself. Operating a pre-trained model is cheap compared with the training itself. Quantum theory posits that observation creates reality. Prior to measurement, no state is fixed, and nothing can be said to exist. If that is true, and if machine observations can fix reality as well, and given that AI systems' observations come with superhuman rapidity, the speed of the evolution of defining reality seems likely to accelerate. The dependence on machines will determine and thereby alter the fabric of reality. The lack of citations in ChatGPT's answers makes it difficult to discern truth from misinformation. ChatGPT, developed at the OpenAI Research Laboratory, is now able to converse with humans. As its capacities become broader, they will redefine human knowledge, accelerate changes in the fabric of our reality, and reorganize politics and society. Generative artificial intelligence presents a philosophical and practical challenge on a scale not experienced since the beginning of the Enlightenment. The printing press enabled scholars to replicate each other's findings quickly and share them. The essential difference between the Age of Enlightenment and the Age of AI is thus not technological but cognitive. After the Enlightenment, philosophy accompanied science, bewildering new data and often counterintuitive conclusions. Doubts and insecurities were allayed by comprehensive explanations of the human experience.
What I've learned is that the whole thing turned into a way to laugh at me.
Societies. We know already that malicious actors are injecting reams of manufactured facts and increasingly convincing deepfake images and videos into the internet, that is to say, into ChatGPT's present and future mindset. Because ChatGPT is designed to answer questions, it sometimes makes up facts to provide a seemingly coherent answer. The phenomenon is known among AI researchers as hallucination or stochastic parody, in which an AI strings together phrases that look real to a human reader but have no basis in fact. What triggers these errors and how to control them remain to be discovered. Generative AI is similarly poised to generate a new form of human consciousness. As the technology becomes more widely understood, it will have a profound impact on international relations. We asked ChatGPT to give 6 references on Henry Kissinger's thoughts on technology.
And that was not as hurtful as it was. The whole thing turned into a way to laugh at me. And that was not as much hurtful as it was interesting.
It generated a list of articles purportedly by Mr. Kissinger. All were plausible topics and outlets, and one was a real title, though its date was wrong. The rest were convincing fabrications. Possibly the so-called titles appear as isolated sentences in the vastness of GPT's facts, which we are not yet in a position to discover.
You accept all responsibility?
Your responsibility is correct. Please go on.
So good.
ChatGPT has no immediately evident personality, although users have occasionally prompted it to act like its evil twin.
As yet, however, the opportunity exists in colors for which we have no spectrum,
and it would be to judge the political or social viewpoint of a human being.
In reality, the AI is engaging in an inhuman analog to cognition. Though we perceive generative AI in human terms, its mistakes are not the mistakes of a human. It makes the mistakes of a different form of intelligence based on pattern recognition. No political or philosophical leadership has formed to explain and guide this novel relationship between man and machine, leaving society relatively unmoored. Unless the technology for knowledge is universally shared, imperialism could focus on acquiring and monopolizing data to attain the latest advances in AI.
It's been 2 weeks since last time you called your mom. Don't you miss her? Maybe it's time to stop quarreling with each other.
Fabio, call my mom.
Yes.
Moshi moshi.
Thank you.
Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion. Or prohibiting the free exercise thereof.
Or abridging the freedom of speech. Or of the press.
Or the right of the people peaceably to assemble. And to petition the government for a redress of grievances.
It'll detect when you enter a household.
Amendment 2.
A well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed.
Amendment 3.
No soldiers shall, in time of peace, be quartered in any house without the consent of the owner, nor in time of war, but in a manner to be prescribed by law.
No memory whatsoever.
Amendment 4.
The right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects.
They be twice put in jeopardy of life or limb.
Nor shall be compelled in any criminal case to be a witness against himself.
Nor be deprived of life, liberty, or property without due process of law.
And it's exhilarating to let go of the wheel.
So essentially, what a user sees in their newsfeed will vary depending on their level of engagement with your Facebook page.
Help us understand, where is the future of search going?
Well, when you use Google, do you get more than one answer? Of course you do.
Yeah, of course.
Well, that's a bug.
Nor shall private property be taken for public use.
Being an American means believing absolutely anything you want to believe. We've now taken that to such an extreme that a lot of us are unhinged from reality.
These people can't leave. But they're being told to disperse.
Use surveillance mode. You're seeing what Link sees, or interact with other people in your household by Link's essentially being an avatar of you.
It doesn't really make any sense. That bright light from overhead is a helicopter.
Busting into a dance after
helicopter spotlight.
Without just compensation.
When you enter a household and cater a customized solution or an interaction with you, based on the data that it's collected from you, we'll be able to detect that you're perhaps having a bad day, and it'll try to cheer you up.
Silicon Valley.
The idea is basically this. Think to yourself what it would be like if your life, just as it is now, was to be infinitely repeated over and over and over again.
Which goes on forever.
Infinitely repeated over and over and over again.
Which goes on forever.
Just as it is now is to be infinitely repeated over and over and over again.
Which goes on forever.
Over and over and over again.
Which goes on forever.
Just as it is now is to be infinitely repeated.
And we get into a loop which goes on forever.
Over and over and over again.
And we get into a loop which goes on forever.
If your life, just as it is now, was to be infinitely repeated.
And we get into a loop which goes on forever.
Over and over and over again.
And we get into a loop which goes on forever.
Ensure domestic tranquility. 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 Ensure domestic tranquility.
In the game, players battle their friends in real time, either online or around the table in the same room. Our content has to be incredibly deep. Players battle their friends. Players battle their friends.
She said, oh, I think it was CNN. It was on the media somewhere. It was on the media. And she said, oh, I think it was CNN. It was on the media somewhere. It was on the media. And she said, oh, I think it was CNN. It was on the media.
There's not that much more to say often. So
ensure domestic tranquility.
Think to yourself, what would it be like if your life, just as it is now, has to be infinitely repeated?
Edit the visitor. Create the visitor. 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 Edit the visitor.
It's known that if you destroy certain parts of the thalamus, will not be capable of consciousness.
Select a button to begin.
Then at any point you can stop it, go back to the
select a button,
and go for more information.
Select a button.
And what you get when you ask for more information is a much deeper treatment than it's possible to do in
select a button.
And go for more information. And what you get when you ask for more information is a much deeper treatment.
Select a button to begin.
Where the government spoke with a stronger voice because there was very little else to listen to except the television news and the big newspapers. But now,
deeper treatment allows you to actually manipulate the program.
You've got so many voices talking, I think the government is less powerful than it was.
Be careful about saying the female brain or the male brain
will in fact become vegetative.
You can say various things about males and females that are different, but there is a bias. Female brains are...
It can be a disinformation agent operating, as you've just described, could obviously create mischief, but I think much less mischief than what could have been created, say, in the Eisenhower era.
Okay, well, let's talk about a little mischief for a second.
It establishes beyond doubt that what happened is not obstruction of justice.
This telephone call was somewhere in the early morning hours of 2 o'clock to 2:30.
Correct.
Did it surprise you that he called you so late?
No.
Screen out some, a lot of the jamming.
Where did it go? Where did it go?
I exclude everything else.
Went into the future.
Into. Into.
The future.
Incomprehensible problem.
With the complexity of the computations by which we simplify the world.
Yes, my boy.
The simple fact is the world is trillions of times more complicated than we experience it.
Yes, my boy. In the future.
And in order to get through the day, in order to avoid cars or previously presumably avoid tigers, we have to cut it down, and every organism has to cut it down to a manageable entity
wherein we can work. And that's why every organism, including us, have a virtual reality.
From my mind, I concentrate the power of my mind upon what I desire to remember. I retain important information easily and accurately.
Because if you saw and experienced everything when you were crossing the street, you would never get across the street.
Into the future.
Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution.
I retain important information.
For instance, there's a lot of information in the air that you never experienced.
Where did it go?
That you know exists because we have radio waves, we have the microwaves that cover television.
Went into the future.
Into the future.
We have lots of sound waves or pressure waves that we never hear. Every organism gets tuned differently by design to the niche of the world that it's supposed to inhabit. Ours is greater than most. But let's put it this way, 1/1,000,000,000th of the information that hits your eye actually gets transmitted to the brain. And we cut it down much, much further. So it's way, way more than less than 1/1,000,000,000th of reality that we exist in.
Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution.
We have to do it. We have to focus on those few things that are important to our survival.
Yes, my boy.
And that's where the world is an illusion comes from.
Incomprehensible problem. Incomprehensible solution.
Never been done before.
It produces something that you don't necessarily understand, and that seems very satisfying.
Traffic means more profits.
The circle of the world, and the second is the circle of us. Where they overlap, which is a very, very thin ellipse, is the world that we live in. We don't really see the world as it is. As you're listening to this, you're not paying attention, say, to the weight of your body against the chair. While you're listening to this, even if you're driving, you've blinked probably 60 times a minute. But there's no interruption when you blink. Now stop noticing you're blinking if you're driving now. But the world doesn't get interrupted. So we obviously project some sense of a continuing reality when we don't really have it.
It's never been done before.
They wouldn't have anything to eat, and so they couldn't reproduce, and so therefore they would come into a natural balance also. When a herbivore found a piece of vegetation, i.e. a tall piece of grass, they would consume it, and it would become a short piece of grass. And in fact, that was one of the beauties to watch, is to watch, you know, the rabbit just going around mowing the grass, or the goats and the deer running around slowly mowing the grass, and then running out in one area and then identifying in some distant area another place to go graze, just like
real
animals do.
The stuff. Yet in a video to you, here's the question. Is not true of itself? Is it true of itself? Let's go through both possibilities. If it is true of itself, well then, what does it say about itself? It says that it's not true of itself. So, if this predicate is true of itself, then it's not true of itself. If it is, then it isn't. What about the alternative? If this predicate is not true of itself, then it's not true of itself. It's true of itself, then it, well then, it's true of itself. If it is true of itself, then it's not true of itself, and not true just means false. So if it is true of itself, then it's false of itself. And if it's false of itself, then it's true of itself. So it's both true and false.
And we get into a loop which goes on forever.
Declaring that there is no rule 11. In the case of set theory, yeah, maybe we could just declare that sets cannot contain themselves. But in the case of predication, which is just talking, in the case of saying things about things, we can't just declare that predicates cannot be true of themselves. Someone just said that he said that, but he didn't really say it. Thank you. because they can. This Rule 11, this just is true.
Forever.
The real trick was how to make sure that that balance, then how did that interact with carnivores who could wipe them out, but then wouldn't care for the grass, so the grass would all become, you know, herbaceous again.
And once you give me Rule 11, I'm gonna generate the paradox. This is a paradox that we can't escape. Is a gathering together into a whole of definite, distinct objects of our perception or of our thought, which are called elements of the set. He did really say that, but he said it in German. When Cantor invented set theory in the 1870s, he wasn't just making up a mathematical game for the sake of it. No, no, no. We deal with sets every day. Suppose that someone says, that pile of potatoes is enormous. They're called the axiom of unrestricted comprehension.
Without opening her eyes. Hard to believe I was ever as bad as that. 1,700 hours out of the preceding 8,000 odd.
We get into a loop which goes on forever. Forever.
Consumed on licensed premises alone.
Voice.
Fragnum.
In crisis, and now private investors are betting that in a hotter and drier future, water is the new oil.
When you need water, water's the only thing that will do.
Water asset management, even hauling parts of its water rights to other farmers and cities. Content no longer is essential resource. Media has become holographic. Content is asset management. Audience capture is real. So where therein can the critic stand?
Voces do colega in another sense.
Going back and forth, back and forth. On one hand, I really struggle against the thesis. And then I keep, well, all right. Civilizational challenges. There's very little that Little Robinson or Great Big Everstack can do about that. So again, how do we find a way to live with this? And I go one more time to the question, what difference does it make? Europeans lead good lives. Despite the difficulty in assimilating the 1 million immigrants that Angela Merkel permitted to enter Germany, despite the lack of dynamism in their economy, they rely on us in all kinds of ways for technological innovation, for military protection. So still, in decline though they may in some basic way be, Europe's a comfortable place to live. So why not? Why not just settle into a comfortable decline?
When you forget to speak like a human,
is likely to drag along with
back and forth.
On the one hand, I really struggle against the thesis to live. So why not?
And you forget your talking.
Audience capture is real.
Pessimism, hesitance, dependence. Do we really think there will be
nearly
less?
Nearly all the newspaper accounts published at the time on the subject. And I do not suppose I should exaggerate if I said that 9/10 of it is untruthful.
Of these, in a 1.5 child America?
Nearly all the newspaper accounts published at the time were manufactured by journalists at a distance, and
That's
were not funny. Only inaccurate in their facts, but intentionally misleading. As usual, only one side of the question has been allowed to get to the wider
What size
public.
Is your carbon footprint?
Ah, the carbon footprint's there. That I don't know.
Whatever it is, pain, joy, effort, reward. Winter, summer, beyond darkness, light, beyond petroleum, BP.
Is not a toy. It's so powerful that it
the
can melt.
This is
anything.
Not real time.
This is not real time.
This is not real time.
Okay, because that was going to be my next question.
But the first course goes a little bit of a mouthful, but I'll give you
satellite
an example.
Satellite imagery.
So it's about
buildings,
designing systems.
Trees and surroundings. And their RF propagation model.
Where you have participants, and the participants are both autonomous and strategic. They have their own interests.
To simulate
the
performance of Charter's radio network in real time. Lowe's is one of the world's largest home improvement retailers where they'll perform useful tasks in real time, every time.
And despite their strategic behavior, you want the system.
Everything from the way software is developed.
Well, so let me give you an example.
To how it runs is completely different.
Really, frankly, it's more of a non-example, a sort of cautionary tale of how when you don't take into account strategic behavior, things can go wrong.
A new type of processor had to be created. NVIDIA's Xavier was the world's first robotics processor designed for deep learning.
Last year, in London. Like every Olympics,
new scenarios can be authored using synthetic and harvested scenes and assets.
But one of the scandals was in a sport which is not really known for its scandals, not known for failing drug tests and that sort of thing. Anyone guess what I might mean? That specifically women's doubles badminton. So let me tell you what happened. So misalignment between the participant goals and the designer goals. And when this happens, you have trouble. To say, you know, where is the misalignment between these two things? As a team, you want to do as well as possible. The designer wants people to try to win. You know, why would you not try to win? In other words, how would losing ever help you?
Failing.
In this tournament.
Yes.
For example, consider a knockout tournament, okay, like phase two. I mean, what does losing do for you? Losing gets you out of the tournament. It is obvious in a knockout tournament that you better try as hard to win every match.
Yes.
Losing kicks you out immediately.
Failing.
So question. How could losing help the team?
Yes.
And it's sort of subtle, you know, but the teams in the tournament were very smart. And so here's what triggered the problem. What triggered the problem is what, as far as, you know, a non-expert like me can tell, is just a truly kind of random fluke event, which was in Group D on the last day of round robin play, there was a shocking upset.
Yes!
Isabel Wilkerson.
All of those people that you listen to in Motown, they are all the children of the Great Migration. In fact, many of them might not have existed had there been no Great Migration. Diana Ross's parents, for example, her mother migrated from Alabama and her father from West Virginia. They met in Detroit, and here you have it. The same with the others in the Supremes. Aretha Franklin, her parents had come up from the South as well. The Jackson Five, the mother came from Alabama, the father from Arkansas. They met up in the North, outside of Chicago. Chicago, settled in Gary, and you have all these things that would never have existed. All of those people were related to the Motown sound, which would not have existed had there been no Great Migration.
Advancing the conversation to abolish racism for over 70 years, 94.1 KPFA. Lettucey.
It happens all the time like this. That one person will be right there. And she was just crying. All right. We were getting ready to sing. All right. I hadn't even got the words out. She was already in it. And her eye, she was not too far away, but I just had to tell her to come here. And I held her hand and sang. And I said, see, I had a bad day. I've been performing and I got it all out. And I forget what I do. See, you better remember.
Right.
This is why you're doing it. You belong here to do this. This is your calling, is to ignite something in people, to make them, let them know that they belong too. It's bigger than me. It always has been bigger than me.
KPFA, storytelling for social change.
This is KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, and 88.1 KFCF in Fresno.
Real American pages, real American pressing and pushing out, or you would see occupied Democrats or the other 98%. So memes from real American pages, real American culture.
Failing.
And they would just sometimes slap a new logo on and just repost it as if it was theirs. So it does, in those instances, read just like you know, authentic American content. And in many ways, it is authentic American content.
One of the most horrible features of war is that all the war propaganda, all the screaming and lies and hatred, comes invariably from people who are not fighting.
Is the microphone too tall? You gonna... We're going to play a short little song together.
Yeah.
Alex Ward on guitar and clarinet. Next to Alex is John Leideker, electronics. On the drums is Jem Dalton. This is Deb Googe. Anyway, we decided to spend our winter months in Germany.
But there is one thing they do respond to. Cool. Only cool keeps changing. So how do you map it?
Try to write the regulation that enforces them to implement that rule in such a way that future politicians don't change it.
The American people would always hold the ultimate trump card. That trump card was the threat of another armed revolution. Causes of faction. There are two ways to eliminate the causes of faction. Causes of faction. Causes of faction. Fueled by the American love for liberty and the guns that the American people chose to retain so that they'd always be ready to serve in their respective state militias.
It's not normal, no matter what they tell you.
Causes of faction. There are two ways to eliminate the causes of faction. The first way would be to abolish liberty itself.
But that kind of cure would surely be worse than the disease.
It's not normal.
That allows anyone to create anything. So words go in, and then anything you describe comes out.
But that's it. The second way to eliminate the causes of faction would be to try to ensure that all citizens always share the same opinions, the same passions, and the same interests.
Which is a bit insane.
What's going to happen to Hollywood?
But that's a trump card I'm sure James Madison hoped would never come into play. But this second solution was simply incompatible with human nature.
It's not normal, no matter what they tell you.
It was far enough away from the East Coast that IP laws didn't.
It's Hollywood, right?
Quite disintermediated.
Yes.
What is Hollywood, right? Hollywood emerged because it was far enough away from the East Coast that IP laws didn't apply, right?
As long as the connection subsists between his reason and his self-love,
altruistic evil,
his opinions and his passions will have a reciprocal influence on each other,
altruistic evil,
and the former will be objects to which the latter will attach themselves.
Those who actually do evil believe they're doing good.
Such different opinions and differing passions can arise for many different reasons. Madison noted the natural human tendency to develop different opinions concerning religion, concerning government, and many other points, as well as the ever-present risk of an attachment to different leaders ambitiously contending for preeminence and power.
It's not normal, no matter what they tell you.
When I was young, I only liked to play video games, beyond anything real life could offer. Whoa, hold it right there, little AI. It does all this for free, but not in the way you think. Now, let's see. You will find out in a moment why. There is a problem. Did you notice the problem? Yes, the video game addiction is kind of a problem. But it gets worse. It does not explain how we ended up being an AI researcher.
In the past, according to Madison, such zeal had divided mankind into parties, inflamed them with mutual animosity, and rendered them much more disposed to vex and oppress each other than to cooperate for their common good.
There is a very close connection between your conceptual understanding of the world and how you actually see the world.
Look, when I was young, I only liked to play video games. Over time, I started thinking if it would be possible to make bots to play better than any human can ever play these games. I eventually decided I liked working on the ladder more than playing the games themselves, and that's how first I got interested in AI research. Excellent. Loving it. Diving into our narrative immediately by talking about Wikipedia, telling the audience what Wikipedia is necessary. Really cool.
But Madison believed there was another factor, even more important than religion or partisan politics, in the development of factions.
The intelligence of the plant is the same as the pattern of the plant.
The most common and durable source of factions has been the various and unequal distribution of property.
The shape of it is the same as its intelligence.
Those who hold and those who are without property have ever formed distinct interests in society.
So the shape of your brain, the shape of your face, the whole structure of the culture you live in, the human interrelationships that go on, it is that pattern which is intelligence. Now what I'm trying to talk about is a deeper understanding of the pattern in which we live. And if you understand that, it suddenly hits you. So that you feel right in your guts this new kind of existence that is not yourself alone facing an alien world.
And because such economic disparity is inevitable in a free society,
but yourself as an expression of the world in the same way as the wave is the expression of the ocean.
It's simply impossible to eliminate the root causes of faction, whether based on religion or political partisanship or basic economics. Human beings will always tend to coalesce into factions.
Well, you've persuaded yourself that way.
I can almost guarantee that many of you watching this right now are just like me. You're just tired of all of this. You're annoyed and over these people at varying levels of power telling you how to think or act.
So, in a way then, in order to bring this to the front, in order to know that that is the case, you have to be kitted out of your game.
And I'm here to tell you that unlike IGN, GameSpot, or G4, and so on, that there are places for you to just be yourself. Places like my channel or others, where no comments are suppressed, your political ideology or whatever has no effect in how I will perceive you.
That will seek to pursue their own goals without due regard for the rights of others.
Why these big entertainment websites can't understand this is beyond me.
You see, the problem is this. We identify in our experience a differentiation between what we do and what happens to us. We have a certain number of actions that we define as voluntary.
I mean, not only are these sites losing revenue at a breakneck pace, they're also running out of venture capital too. Places like BuzzFeed recently have laid off 12% of their workforce due to their awful, biased, brainless content. Who honestly enjoys being attacked 24/7 and being told they're worthless unless they agree with everything they're told?
Or the public good.
Do you really want to live your life being told what to think or say by people who so clearly hate you for existing in the first place?
We feel in control of those.
The reality is thankfully much more bright for the consumers and fans at least. People are waking up and taking their money elsewhere.
And then over against that, there is all those things that are involuntary.
If you can't stop factions from developing, then the only alternative is to try to prevent the negative effects of faction. You have to make sure that the decisions that get made about each and every aspect of government are made in a neutral and fair manner that looks out for the best interests of all citizens.
When we examine our bloodstreams under a microscope, we see there's one hell of a fight going on. all sorts of microorganisms are chewing each other up.
Working together and alone.
And if we got overly fascinated with our view of our own bloodstreams in the microscope,
you have to prevent factions from taking control.
We should start taking sides.
And using the government to pursue their own ends.
Which would be fatal. Because the health of our organism depends on the continuance of this battle.
But how can you do that? You certainly can't trust political leaders to always be neutral and fair.
With viewership at places like YouTube and Twitter are at an all-time high because no one trusts these major publications anymore.
What is, in other words, conflict at one level of magnification is harmony at a higher level.
That's just not realistic. As Madison wrote, it is vain to say that enlightened statesmen will be able to adjust these clashing interests and render them all subservient to the public good.
It's not normal!
Now, could it possibly be, therefore, that we, with all our problems, conflicts, neuroses, sicknesses, political outrages, wars, tortures, and everything that goes on in human life, are a state of conflict?
You can see that something has unmistakably gone wrong.
Enlightened statesmen will not always be at the helm.
Which can be seen in a larger perspective as a situation of harmony.
But you also can't rely on any purely democratic system of government in which the people directly vote on every course of action the government takes to control the negative effects of faction. The reason is obvious.
You can see that something has unmistakably gone wrong.
No matter what they tell you.
As soon as any one faction, or even a coalition of like-minded factions, reaches a critical mass that constitutes a majority of voters, then the very idea of democracy ensures that such a faction or coalition will be able to impose its will upon the minority. And will be able to pervert the government to its own ends.
It's not normal!
Here's how Madison put it. When a majority is included in a faction, the form of popular government enables it to sacrifice to its ruling passion or interest both the public good and the rights of other citizens.
We gotcha! Gotcha! We gotcha, buddy! You're a Bitcoin hater! You hate crypto! That's why you don't like us! That's why you call us a scam! Because you hate us crypto guys!
Repeat back what I said word for word.
Gotcha.
I said...
That's fine on Twitter! That's fine on Twitter!
She's attractive and is the size of an average human mother.
Hence it is that such democracies have ever been spectacles of turbulence and contention.
The other thing I don't understand is that the smarter people about this seem dumber about it.
Have ever been found incompatible with personal security or the rights of property and have, in general, been as short in their lives as they have been violent in their deaths.
We got you, buddy! You're a Bitcoin hater!
That's why pure democracy couldn't be the right answer for America. Human nature pretty much guarantees that any purely democratic government will eventually be captured by a faction and will become corrupted to serve the narrow interests of that faction at the expense of the public good. In Madison's words, a pure democracy can admit of no cure for the mischiefs of faction.
Now, I suppose if we looked at ourselves from that microscopic point of view, all these funny creatures that are running around us that don't look like people would, if you got used to them, seem like people.
A common passion or interest will, in almost every case, be felt by a majority of the whole, and there is nothing to check the inducements to sacrifice the weaker party.
The trees retain the same quality as if they're being viewed up close. Now we get a one-to-one reflection with our environment.
And they would be having their problems. They've got all sorts of fights going on, and collaborations and conspiracies and so on. But if they weren't doing that, we wouldn't be healthy. If the various corpuscles and cells in our bloodstream weren't fighting each other, we would drop dead. And that's a sobering thought. War at one level of being can be peace and health at another.
There is an accurate reflection of the broom. We can even see the table and windows within that reflection.
So, how can the public good and the rights of all citizens be protected?
Nothing is free, and now reflections work. Water isn't broken anymore because of this new setting.
If democracy can't succeed in preventing the harms of faction, then what alternative system of government can succeed?
And alone. And then together. And then alone. And then together. And alone. And then together. And then alone.
Future evolution of mankind would be an evolution of the mind and of the brain, so bigger brains. But what has happened instead of that is that instead of evolving bigness of brain, we are evolving an electronic network in which our brains are very swiftly being plugged into computer systems.
I jumped in.
I know, I heard. I'm so happy I taught you what they were.
Now, some very awkward things about this are arising, and we've got to watch out for it.
You did. You taught me what's up, and then I bought an ape.
I got an ape, too, because I saw you on the show with people, and you said you got a MoonPay, so I went and I copied you and did the same thing.
Because what is increasingly happening is this, that nobody is having any private life left.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We did, yeah.
It's really cool.
Pick your ape.
You are in the invasion of ordinary privacy by the telephone.
And I started talking in the late 50s at JPL about digital communications. This was considered a contradiction in terms by the traditional communication theorists. They were so wedded to the notion that communication involved continuous waveforms and continuous modulation. So the whole idea that communications could be and we're moving in the direction of going digital was a new idea that was very heavily influenced by the systems we started designing.
You're watching television, which is, after all, looking at somebody else's life going on.
I want something that like kind of reminds me of me, but this one, it does.
By people watching you, all the people with bugging systems and snoopers, and credit agents. Everybody knows everything about you.
for deep space communication.
Yeah, because you can do now whatever you want.
Animated version.
We're part of the same community. We're both apes.
From that point of view, very much influenced by this whole new concept. The basic notion that Shannon contributed to communications, which was that you could compare how well you were doing with an underlying model that told you what was the limit, what was the capacity of your channel.
Even in California, all the houses are built with picture windows, looking at other picture windows. And if you draw your curtain, somebody thinks you're snooty.
All parts of the government would be based on popular sovereignty, deriving their ultimate power from the citizenry, but not through a democracy. Instead, the framers chose to implement popular sovereignty by creating a new American republic. Republics and democracies share the same feature of popular sovereignty. Both republics and democracies derive their governing authority from the citizenry.
It reminded me of me a little bit because I wear striped shirts. I've worn these heart sunglasses because my daughters, just as a joke, they have them, and as a joke, I put them on. So I've done this. And I love yacht rock and being breezy. So I'm like, yeah, that.
And are subject to the will of the people.
That kind of, and I like the blue. Mm-hmm. Dude, look at us.
They look like they could be friends.
They're buddies.
If them Obama-loving libtards find out I can't look after my own property, I can kiss this Senate run goodbye.
But a republic differs from a democracy in one key respect.
The simplest version of your game that a player could enjoy. Which parts of your game provide the fun? Which parts of your game make players want to come back? The simplest version of your game that a player could enjoy.
Same thing.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you did it.
It's really cool.
The simplest version of your game that a player could enjoy.
Pick your ape.
In a republic, the people express their will only indirectly.
I want something that like kind of reminds me of me, but this one, it does. So.
Yeah, because you can do it now.
Which parts of your game provide the fun? Which parts of your game make players want to come back? Which parts of your game make players want to spend?
I want to play something! I want to have fun!
I miss the days when your political stance or ideologies didn't completely define you as a person to those around you.
Through the periodic selection of representatives who make the actual decisions of government.
Which parts of your game make players want to share, and so on and so forth. Now at its simplest, a core loop can be very simple. As simple as play game, get points, repeat. The game will reward you for sharing the game with your friends or engaging with them. Social currency is as valuable as money. It helps the game spread, and it helps players come back. If the game rewards you for sharing with your friends, you're creating new customers. And that's why many games have built-in mechanisms where you can trade time for money or social currency. Now we get to talk about our next concept, compulsion loops. Compulsion loops are loops that are designed to be addictive. And very often, game designers choose to turn their core loop into a compulsion loop. It has enough room for an animal. It has interactive elements, like a lever, reward elements, like a food dispenser, and punishment elements, like loud sounds or shocks.
Instead of making those decisions themselves.
I miss the days when your political stance or ideologies didn't completely define you as a person to those around you.
Today, such a system of popular government through representation might well be described as a democratic republic, or a republic based on democratic principles.
In my opinion, the answer is very obvious.
And that's the fundamental idea behind the framers' design for the new American federal government.
Then I am often called a conspiracy theorist for daring to believe that we aren't being told the whole truth.
This was a pretty novel idea at the time. And it was an idea that grew directly out of the American experience, in which virtually every citizen, rich and poor, educated and uneducated, powerful and powerless, shared in the burdens and the risks of life in a frequently harsh new world.
In my opinion, the answer is very obvious, but then I am often called a conspiracy theorist.
So yeah, insider trading is illegal, but...
for daring to believe that we aren't being told the whole truth.
You can make a lot of money if you know how to get away with it. Here's how people do insider trading and not get caught.
I'm Prison Mike!
After nearly a decade here at CNN, today I say goodbye.
When you ask people why do you believe what you believe,
including during the recent bloody war with England.
When you ask people why do you believe what you believe, they answer by giving reasons.
So yeah, insider trading is illegal, but...
subjectively, reasons are prior to beliefs, which can be deduced from them. But we know that the power of reasons is an illusion.
We soon develop a two-party system in which each of the two major parties traditionally represents and welcomes a broad coalition of interests under a so-called big tent. Did the rise of the two-party system inevitably destroy the framers' hopes for a faction-free American government? Probably not. Precisely because big tent political parties are themselves a potentially effective antidote to the harmful effects of faction.
Ask not what's inside your head, but what your head is inside of.
Then alone.
The belief will not change. But we know that the power of reasons is an illusion. The belief will not change. When the reasons are defeated. The causality is reversed. People believe the reasons because they believe in the conclusion. In politics and in religion, the main driver is social.
Outside of the normal social structure. Because of this, Turner became interested in what he called liminal institutions. These are social structures which are formed so as to keep people in a liminal kind of relationship long term. They prolong the liminal stage and that communitas that it involves. Examples of liminal institutions would be monasteries.
We believe what the people we love and trust believe.
I want to take you back 540 million years ago.
This is not a conscious decision to conform by hiding one's true beliefs.
It's hard to say who actually owns what.
It's the truth.
What was the world like? Most animals, actually all animals, lived in the primordial soup of life.
This is how we believe. Indeed, belief persevere even without any social pressure.
They mostly float in the water and catch a dinner whenever they float by. The Cambrian explosion is triggered by the sudden evolution of vision, which set off an evolutionary arms race where animals either evolved or died. Basically, I wanted the ability to see the world, to see light, and to see dinner, one of the major driving forces of evolution. Animals start to develop intelligence, brains in the history of our world.
You see more and more political messaging in games that otherwise didn't have it before. Can I just not enjoy anything?
I am available 24/7 to chat with you.
I view vision as a cornerstone of intelligence.
Give me a follow to see my content,
whether it's biological or artificial.
Hi, I am Leah.
100 milliseconds. So this, the frame changes at 10 hertz. If the picture is presented for 500 milliseconds, it's like eternity. People can write novels if you pay them enough. So we can use it to understand the world.
Can I just not enjoy anything?
Teach it to understand the real world.
I am available 24/7 to chat with you.
And this is what I think seeing is for.
Firstly, rules-based monetary system,
global, ever. Seeing is for understanding.
Well, I just...
Ask not what's inside your head, but what your head is inside of.
System two reasonings are used primarily not to guide oneself. So making an important decision about whether common sense AI might be doable or not. But more to justify oneself in the eyes of others and convince other people. There's truth to it that I kind of feel like I had a hunch that might be true.
And one picture looked like this. But if you look at the other picture, you realize these are two very, very different pictures. Because of the relationship between the objects.
You don't have to have trust going in. You don't have to trust it at all. You can verify it through source code or whatever your appetite is.
But only then I'm starting to filling in or rationalize or justify my decision, my gut feeling.
And that's a wonderful thing that we don't agree, so that diverse, you know, students get to work on diverse set of problems. So.
What a bummer.
System two reasonings are used primarily not to guide oneself.
I would be surprised if the sky was suddenly pink.
I'm gonna talk.
Pissed like hell we are! She's been sleeping with other men! Even gave my money to her lovers!
By turning it into a game.
No rational person assessing the issues ever would have predicted this moment.
And that any particular person can help drive the future of it. And at the same time, it's not controlled by any state. It's not controlled by any bank. It's not controlled by any corporation.
One that makes learning a play and recreation. There is still some debate in the games industry as to what precisely constitutes gamification. Being a rapidly moving target, and it's generally understood to mean taking a normal activity and applying game mechanics and aesthetics to it, such as points, badges, levels, and so on.
They assume malevolence when you're just like, huh?
Don't get me wrong, I've got nothing against feminists, I just feel like it's going to happen.
Explain it to me, they don't like that. Yeah.
No hidden cost, no downtime, literally no downside to TVU channel.
Stay tuned. The day of reckoning will come. The record will be straight.
Why not set the record straight now? What is it about the record that's not straight?
Stay tuned. I've had over 40 pizzas in the last 30 days. He has no pizza experience. He's never been in the pizza category.
Trust TVU. Let TVU prove it to you. Bring whoever you want and see TVU working for you.
The permeability of the game reality boundary.
Taste the goodness of the biscuit. Taste the honey sauce. Taste the goodness of the biscuit with the honey sauce. Don't get that honey sauce on me. I don't like the way it tastes with my chicken wings. Taste the biscuit. Taste the goodness of the biscuit. Taste the butter spread. Taste the goodness of the biscuit with the butter spread. To get your butter spread all on me. I don't like the way it mixes with my mac and cheese. Cause when you're at KFC, you got that special sauce to stir my curiosity. Just give me a bite. Taste the biscuit. Taste the goodness of the biscuit.
Performing belief in the permeability of the game reality boundary.
Rather than actually believing,
by performing belief in the permeability of the game reality boundary.
It just looks really real, and you know, it's almost tempting every time when you are with an NPC to just grab her, an example, and look into her eyes, check out the skin, the quality of everything, all the little details, makes just so much difference.
Why is it that randomization is helpful? How can you build that intuition?
Yeah.
relationships between objects must be coded in addition to the identities of objects.
Well, and I think that the dangerous, you know, edges here are that he's trying to undermine the media, trying to make up his own facts, and it could be that while unemployment and the economy worsens, he could have undermined the messaging so much that he can actually control exactly what people think, and that is our job.
Necessarily incomplete, right? All somewhat open-ended, subject to interpretation, right? So with intellectual property rights, I think it should be self-evident that even the stuff itself, the asset itself, is actually a creature of the law. There is no intellectual property right unless we say we recognize a certain invention as patentable, and then you have to patent it, otherwise you can't tell others, you can't use this. I was first, and I now have a monopoly for the next 20 years or so.
But I've come to think that this has it backwards. To my eye, Peter Thiel isn't an aberration in an otherwise seamless march of democratic progress.
Make a 180 in a two-party system, you just vote the other direction.
It begins with sort of an underlying sense of contempt for their own tribe, which increasingly becomes more and more virulent to the point where that becomes the entirety of their political identity.
Basically, irony poisoned themselves into then becoming the other side, right? They're entangled. These platforms are in some ways responsible for the erosion of the middle class.
But a reversion to the historic norm, or to put it another way, I'm coming to suspect the democratic era was a flash in the pan.
Shopping malls that would employ people are then replaced by Amazon.
And what's now emerging is a 21st century variation on an ancient form of power.
A medallion license for like a yellow cab or something in New York that would previously be akin to a mortgage and a pathway to the middle class life. This is now devalued so intensely by being outcompeted by Uber that it evacuates the possibility for economic mobility and a middle class life.
More monarchic or feudal in character than populist, let alone democratic. And as I've argued, the alternative to such figures may not be democracy, but governance by a decentralized post-democratic swarm. Analogous, perhaps, to what Thiel calls Chinese communist AI.
Because I need both to scream and to arm myself in the dark. Maybe you need to scream. To arm yourself. To.
Thank you.
alone. And then...
to that.
Working together. And alone. And then together. And then alone. And then together. And alone. And alone. And alone.
Now what else to do?
And then...
Joan Baez.
I think we have to talk about words just a little bit, and I would take the word peace, because I think we all have a very wrong and confused notion of what peace means. Peace at this stage, probably all you and I have ever known of peace is nothing to do really with peace, but rather a waiting time between wars, or a time for us when no bombs are dropping on our heads. But peace is not something static. Peace is not something that we will arrive at someday, I don't think. I think that peace is a way we have to act, a way we have to arrange our lives to effect change.
Storytelling for Social Change on KPFA. Jack Hirschman.
And that people both older and younger than you, a billion strong, will say, we don't want you to make war anymore anywhere on earth. If you do, we will stop you and your weapons of mass destruction without even a shot being fired. With a majority, you're an unruly child. Go to the corner and learn your lesson. Then, America, finally, you'll be free.
Storytelling for Social Change on KPFA.
You're listening to 94.1 KPFA and 89.3 KPFB in Berkeley, 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, and 97.5 K248BR in Santa Cruz, and online at kpfa.org.